Hello students, so today we will continue lesson 6 CSS cascading styles. So in the last class we discussed about the font style, and today we will study about the font weight. To see this property, font weight specifies the weight or boldness of the font. Means the character will appear in the bold form, means it will be highlighted, and the possible values for this property are 100 to 900. So between 100 to 900 you can use the value for the font weight property, and also you can use bold, bolder, lighter and normal value. See, the syntax is font weight, and after colon you have to put the value, and the allowed values are you can use lighter, normal, bold, bolder, or 100, 200, 300, 400, 500 till 900. You can use any value out of the given of here. Now the numeric values 100 to 900 is specify the font weights, where each value is a little darker than its predecessor. So the 200 is darker than 100, and 300 is darker than 200, and this 700 is darker than 600. So if you increase the value, so the darkness of the character will increase. Okay. Now the value 400 is taken as normal font weight, whereas 700 is bold font weight. So 400 is taken as the normal. And for the bold, the value is what? 700. So you can use this also, you can use the value also. Now see the syntax. We have set the font weight property for the heading 1 element, h1 element. So this is the selector. So we have selected the tag h1. And for that we are writing the rule CSS rule font weight. This is the property and the value is the bolder. Now braces close. Now see this, this is the inline style. For the paragraph we are writing style equals to in double quotation mark, you have to write the property font family, its value is the monotype cursiva, or the comic sans or cursive. If suppose this is not supported monotype cursiva by one browser, they will see the another value. It will use comic sans. And if the comic sans is also not supported by that browser, it will use the cursive. And the second property we use font weight, and the value we have set lighter. So this is the inline style CSS, and this is the internal style CSS h1. Now the next property we will study the font size. How we set the size of the characters on the web page. Now see, the font size property is used to set the size of a font, and its value can be the absolute, relative size, length or percentage. So absolute value means its the value will be fixed. It sets the font size to a definite value. It is specified like we are using the 20 pixel, 30 pixel, these types of the values are the absolute. And it is specified by using one of the following keywords also you can use. As a font size, and its value you can use double x small, small, large, double x large, or medium. So these 7 types of the values you can use for the absolute, for the property font size, and all these 7 are called the absolute value. Now next the relative value. So how you can set the relative size? The relative size sets the font relative to the surrounding elements. If the surrounding elements is suppose 20 pixel, so if you write the larger, so the current size of the character will be the more than 20 pixel, maybe the 22 pixel. And if you write the smaller, so its size will decrease in comparison to the surrounding elements. So it is specified by using one of the following keywords. So for the relative size, we use two words, smaller or larger. If you want to make your text, current text, larger than the surrounding, so you can use the value font size larger. Now the most common units for specifying the font size are the pixel, pxus, pt, point size is used. At this point size is divided, 1 inch is divided into 72 points, and that value we can use from 1 to 72 for the points. Percentage is used like this. You can give the percentage of the 1 inch as 1200 em also is used for as this is the relative size. So after em you write, before em you write some number, for example 0.5 em, 0.5 means half the current font size. So whatever the font size, suppose current font size you are using 20 pixel, default is 16, so 0.5 will do the half of the 20 pixel. So the em unit is defined relative to the current font size. It is a relative unit, relative size. It is specified in percentage. If you want to specify the font size in percentage, the font size is calculated relative to the parent element. by default the font size is 16 pixel. Now if you do not specify a font size, the default size for a normal text like paragraph is 16 pixel. So 16 pixel is taken as the 1 em. So now see the syntax, font size value is the absolute size. So for the font size you can use the absolute size value, relative size value, length or percentage. So the value for the absolute size is double x, small, small, medium, large, x large, double x large. And for the relative size we use larger or smaller. Now see the here example for the h1 element we are writing the root font size large. For the paragraph C we have written style is equals to font family monotype or C bar font size 50 pixel. This is the absolute size, fixed size. This is the inline style CSS and this is the internal. Now here you can see in the example, now see the thought for the day. This heading, this is the heading H1. See, this is the heading, this heading thought for the day. Property set style equals to font family Georgia. So this is the Georgia style and the size is 250% of the parent element. So means 250% means you are multiplying by 2.5. So if the parent size is 16 pixel, or suppose the current size is 20 pixel, it will become 50 pixel. Now see the next is the paragraph, the more good wishes and the kind feelings. So this paragraph style is set here, paragraph inline style, style equals to font family and the family is here is the monotype or Siva and the size is double x large. Here see another paragraph, it is written in inline style, paragraph style equals to font family monotype or Siva and the font size is smaller. See the surrounding elements, it is smaller and here the surrounding element size is double x large and here it is the comparatively to the previous paragraph the size is smaller. Now see the next paragraph, this is also written in the internal line style equals to font family monotype or Siva, size 50 pixel it is. Okay, now we move to the next page, text properties. See how we set the text properties. So basically the text properties, not text properties, yes, font variant. So we also use the font variant properties to set the font into variants. Here two variants we use, normal or small caps. So normal means it is appear normally, there will be no change, but in the small caps all the letter will be appear in the uppercase. So in small caps all the lowercase characters are converted into the uppercase characters. So however they appear slightly smaller than the original uppercase characters, so size will be little bit smaller. That's why the small caps. So when displaying the output, now see the font variant value, where value goes to the small caps or normal. Two values are allowed for the properties font variant, small caps or normal. As you see in the syntax example, for the heading 1 we have set the font variant small caps, and for the heading 2 font variant normal, and for the paragraph style goes to font variant small caps. This is the inline style CSS. Now see in the output. For this we have set the font variant small caps. See every character is in the capital letter, but its size is smaller, little bit smaller than the original capital letter size. Now the font, if the font variant is set to small caps and no small cap font is available, so the browser will most likely display the text in the uppercase on that place, which is the real size base size. So we can also use the shorthand property for the font. So this property is used as a shorthand method to set all the font properties, that is its style, its weight, its variant, or its size. So in one single declaration, we can set up all the properties for the font. It is basically used for the font size and font family properties, but can also be used to set the font style, font variant, and font weight also. See how we specify the values for the font size and family is mandatory. So these two values you have to specify. This you cannot skip it. Font family and font size. Value specified for the rest of the properties. Value specification for the rest of the properties like style, variant, and weight is optional. That is not mandatory. You can skip it. But the default values will be picked by the browser. So you can also use this property by specifying the line height also, the space between lines. That's for the line heights. The order of the values for the font property should be in the following manner in the sorted notation. First, you write the font style, and after that the font variant, font weight, then font size, then font family. In that order, you pass the value. Now see, in that order only the value is passed. See, first here for the font is the size 15 pixel. Here you see the size 15 pixel. And area and sans serif is the font family, and which comes after the size only. So after this 15 pixel, you cannot use the value for the font weight. You cannot write the bold. Then it will display the error. See here the font style is at italic. See the style value is the italic, and after that the weight bold, italic, bold, and after that the size, font size, that is 12 pixel. After that again the font family. So the order you have to follow: first style, then variant, style, variant, weight, size, family. Now again you can see the property set for the font weight bold. The font variant is small cap. See the font. First you set the bold, then small caps. So here the bold is for the font weight, and after that you are writing the font variant here. Bold is small caps, and after that you are mentioning the size and see stands. So here it is a mistake. So that small caps you write before, because small caps is the size for the font variant, and bold is for the weight, so that weight should be written first. For the style, we use the value italic, normal, or oblique here. So in the paragraph style, font italic, italic, this is the style, small caps, this is the variant, now the weight is the bolder. So you have to be correct, but here it is a mistake. Now, while specifying the values of any sorting property, the order has to be followed strictly. So we have to follow this order strictly while specifying the values for the font in the sorted notation. Okay, so this is all for today, students. In the next class, we will discuss the remaining topic. Thank you for your kind attention.